Hi guys, today I've got a foundation review and it was released earlier this year and I picked up mine from Zaxx in America when I did an order there probably about 3 months ago now. And it is the Clé de Peau Beaute. It is the Radiant Cushion Foundation Dewy. This is the package that it comes in, so it's quite a decent sized box. This has 15 grams of product. It is made in Japan. It has a shelf life of 24 months from date of opening. And I picked up mine in the shade. It is medium ochre and it is 030. Now, this particular foundation from Clé de Peau, this only comes out in 7 shades. And when I was looking at the Clé de Peau website, I had a look at the reviews on this foundation, and probably about 95 to 98% of them are positive, 4 or more stars. But there were a couple with 2 or lower, and I had a quick look at those, and one of them was disappointed with the shade range. And then I noticed a comment from Clé de Peau back to that person, and they just pointed out their other foundations in their range do have more shades. I imagine if this is popular, then I think they will introduce more shades. So I have tried this now probably at least 4 or 5 times since I got it. And for those of you that haven't watched my other videos before I start giving the description of this foundation and showing you what it looks like on, not only here under these lights, but also in natural light as well. I am 53 years old, so I have mature skin and I also have oily skin as well. Now, it is winter here in New Zealand, so we don't have the humidity like we do in summer. So I've really only been trialing this foundation in the beginning of autumn to now. I just wore this again the last couple of days because I hadn't tried it for about a month and I just wanted to see what it was like. Now, I do really like this foundation, but I'll explain a bit more about it later. I think it's great with my oily skin for autumn, winter, and probably early spring. I have a feeling that it probably won't be so great with my oily skin in the middle of summer when there is more humidity. So this foundation is supposed to create a luminous look and blur imperfections. It is $105 American, and this does have refills, and the refills are $75. And as I was saying, this is in 7 shades. But so on their website, they say it is a refillable cushion foundation imbued with 24-hour moisture and buildable coverage. Creates a flawless finish, reminiscent of a fresh morning dew, lasting 6 hours. And they say that it instantly creates a luminous and dewy look while minimizing every imperfection. The cushion foundation glides on with a fresh, hydrating, essence-like texture that restores moisture with every touch-up and improves skin radiance over time. Build your layers of luster for a personalized level of glow and coverage. And they say that in clinical results, when it was tested by it's just 30 women, the foundation had a 16-hour long lasting finish with no shine, crease, fade, or dullness, or dryness, and a radiant finish. And this is formulated with a delicate natural rose fragrance. So this does have a fragrance. I think the fragrance is really lovely. I don't find it overwhelming at all. And some of the main ingredients in this foundation is Light Empowering Enhancer, delivers a naturally radiant finish by creating optimal light diffusion and reflection in and within skin, minimizes the appearance of skin imperfections, and I would agree with that, and amplifies your radiant makeup finish. Dewy Rich Hydrating Formula envelops skin with moisture for a dewy finish that lasts up to 16 hours, provides a fresh, hydrating essence-like texture and a 24-hour moisturizing effect. Glow Control Technology ensures beautiful and even application of the foundation as it is reapplied. It has a Bulgarian Rose Moisturizing Complex, imbues skin with deep moisture to achieve dewy and lustrous skin. And the last bullet point on the website says Skin Empowering Illuminator enhances skin's ability to protect and restore itself from environmental aggressors. And then they do give a list of the ingredients. So if I remember, I will take a screenshot of that and put it up in this video so you can take a look. There's no wonder really that this is a glowy, dewy type of foundation. The second ingredient is glycerin, and that is a great humectant. And also in here, I won't go through them all, but there's also some flower water, there's fruit extracts and root extracts as well. So I'll show you the product itself in a minute. And they do give instructions of how to use this. I haven't been using it like they say in the first step. It says apply following skincare or the application of a pre-makeup base. So I have done all my skincare for the morning, and the last step is sunscreen, and I do put on quite a bit of sunscreen. The one that I use when I've just reapplied it probably about 10 minutes ago, I did put an extra amount under my eyes, because even though I have oily skin, it's really important to keep the under eyes really hydrated so they don't get dried out once I've applied my makeup. It says lightly press the puff, and I'll show you that in a minute, onto the foundation surface 2 or 3 times to allow sufficient foundation to adhere. Gently pat onto the skin using enclosed puff. It also says you can use the Clé de Peau portable brush or the Clé de Peau beauty sponge. They say that is recommended to enhance the application of the foundation and achieve a more beautiful finish. Now, with this foundation, I've applied it using a brush, and I've also applied it using a beauty sponge as well, whether it be my Rafa one or the other beauty sponges that I have. Now, when I get cushion foundations, I don't tend to use the applicator sponge that comes with them. I don't even know whether I've even tried it. I do stick to either brushes or the beauty sponge. So I'll open this up so you can take a look. So inside, the product itself comes in this blue velvet pouch, and also inside the box is the cushion foundation itself, which is already open since I've used this. Packaging itself is really, really beautiful, and just the subtle Clé de Peau logo on the front, and then it has the gold around the edges. And to open it up, you just press it in there and it opens really easily. It does have a generous size mirror inside, and here is the applicator that comes with it. As I said, I haven't used that. I have seen videos where people have used it and it does apply the foundation really lovely. It's just my preference to either use a sponge or a brush. Now, I'm going to use a sponge to apply it today, but I will show you the brushes that I have used applying this foundation. And then inside you have the cover, and then you just click it open, and that is the cushion itself. And I'll just close it back up again. And on the back of this, it has on each corner there, it just says to press. So when you first get this, it hasn't got the cushion in it, and you just click the cushion in, and then when it comes time to replace it, you'll just be able to press under here, open it up, open up the cover, press underneath, and it will just click out again. So as I was saying, I've used this foundation either with a brush or a beauty sponge. So since I'm putting on with a beauty sponge today, I'm just going to show you which brush that I've used. So there's a couple of different ones, and one is the Westman Atelier brush. This is quite dense, and I find this really good for popping on foundation. The other brush that I use, it's in another jar here because I actually used this yesterday and it needs a clean. So if you've got a brush like this, this one is a Chukuhodo one. So it has a lot smaller area here, so it takes a bit longer to put the foundation on. But this is a natural hair brush, but this puts on the foundation really beautifully as well. But you can see the different size type. So any type of foundation brush you have, something that is more dense and it just puts on the foundation really, really beautifully. So I haven't put on any primer yet, but I'm just about to. And the primer that I've been using with this, since I have oily skin, I've used one that's probably not really mattifying, but I don't want a primer that's going to give a dewy finish either. So I've been reaching for either the Dior Forever, this is the Velvet Veil, or I've been using the Hourglass one. So I'm just going to pump out a bit of the Dior Velvet Veil and just pop that on. And once I've put a primer on, I usually just let it sit for about a minute or two before I put any foundation on. I think with this foundation, if I was going to use it in summer, I would have to probably fuss around with it a little bit more since I have oily skin. What I would probably do is spray on a setting spray and then put on a primer and then apply the foundation. But it has been working beautifully in the cooler months, and I do think this is a super flattering foundation, especially for mature skin. I think it looks really gorgeous. So the primer's been sitting for about a couple of minutes now, and I've got a dampened beauty blender, and I've also squeezed out the excess onto a towel. One thing with these cushions, I find that they have probably not more product than other ones have, but it comes out a lot easier. And the first time I used this, I really pushed, I think it might have been the brush that I used, and really pushed it in, and I just picked up too much foundation. So what I do is I just go quite lightly in first, and I just want to pick up enough, and pick up about that much, and just pop it on. I can always add a little bit more, but I do find that a little goes a long way with this foundation. I think it gives a really beautiful finish, and you'll see once I've put it all on the beautiful dewy finish that it gives. So the excess that's on the sponge now, I'll just take that just on my eyelid and under my eye as well. With my other videos, if you've been watching them, I have been using a colour corrector first before I put on foundation. But for today's video, since this is a foundation review, I thought I would just use the foundation and then pop some concealer over the top. So the finish is beautiful, and it says it blurs imperfections, and I would agree with that. It really has diminished the look on my pores there. So this side with none of the foundation on, and this one with one layer. So I will build it up to show you, but first I'm just going to do the other side. I really like using a beauty blender. I don't know if there's a preference whether using a brush, because when I use a brush, I use a stippling motion. But with a beauty blender, I just find that it just helps to push a product in and just gives a really beautiful finish. So that's with one layer on. Now what I'm going to do is just dip the sponge in again and just go over these areas here. I quite like this finish. This is a light heading towards medium. You can make it quite a strong medium, but I'm just going to put some more just over these areas here. I have a sunspot through here. I have a little bit of redness through here that's from broken veins. So I'm just going to add just some more through here. But I quite like this look with the foundation. It's not full coverage, and this is certainly not mask-like in any way. It's really lovely. So I'm just dipping the sponge in again, and I'm just going to go just pop some on those areas. So this builds up really beautifully, this foundation. And when I go to touch it, it is one where if I didn't powder it with my oily skin, it would go from this really beautiful glow and it would start looking quite greasy. But I think if you had even combination normal to dry, I think you would really love this foundation. And especially if you had normal to dry skin, I think only a very light dusting of powder, if any, because the look that you get now, because you haven't got the oily skin, it would just stay like this really gorgeous subtle glow. So I think that the finish is really beautiful. It doesn't emphasize lines. It definitely blurs through my pores here and just gives, I think, an absolutely stunning finish to the skin. I think it is really, really beautiful. And also with popping some of the foundation under my eyes and through here, it doesn't settle into the lines at all. There have been the odd foundations that I've tried and it does do that, and that is a really awful look, but this just gives a gorgeous healthy glow. But as I was saying, when I feel it, I definitely need to powder it down. But first of all, I'm going to put on some concealer, and I'm going to use the Clay de Peau concealer, and this is in the stick form. And how I put this on, there are a few different ways you can put it on, but I like to, because it's a cream formula, I like to put some on my finger and just let it warm up and then rub it between two fingers. And by the time I've done that, it's warmed up the product. And I just start by tapping it in the inner corner and then just tapping it through. And by using my finger, the warmth of my skin just helps the creaminess of the concealer to really meld in. And this is quite a full coverage concealer, and I think it does give a really beautiful finish. So I'm just gonna rub some more together and just pop some under the other eye. I'll just use this finger as well, just so I use all the product. So I've just done my eyebrows and also put some eyeshadow primer on as well. And I've also put a little bit of powder under my eyes. The powder for my face, I'm going to use the Sisley one. If the weather was warmer, I would be reaching for my Chanel powder, because I do find that a little bit more mattifying. But since it is cooler weather at the moment, I'm just going to take the BK Beauty 105. It's not a heavy dusting of powder, but probably not light either, but I have been reaching for this one or the La Prairie one. I've also used it with the Chanel powder as well, and all powders just work really beautifully with it. I would love to try a Clay de Peau powder. I've heard really good things about it, so maybe next time that I do a shop at Harrods, I might pick up one then. So with the light dusting of powder, it doesn't feel like a flat matte at all. It's definitely matted down a little bit, but I think that you can still see this really gorgeous glow through. Now, when I've worn this during the day and gone out, I've taken with me the Hermes powder. That's the pressed one, and that is a little bit mattifying. So if I find I'm getting a little bit of glow through here throughout the day, then that in the pressed powder form is just really easy to reapply. So now I'm just going to put on the rest of my makeup, and then I'll be back, and then later on I'll also show you this in natural light as well. So apart from the mascara and eyeliner with the rest of my makeup, the eyeshadow, the blush, the lipstick, and also lip gloss, they are all Clay de Peau products as well, and I will have them listed and linked in the description box below. So I've had my foundation on now with putting on my makeup and then talking at the start of this video, putting it on. It's probably been close to about 45 minutes now, because I had to do a couple of other things as well, and it is looking really beautiful. I haven't put any extra powder on, but like I said, I probably will in another 2 or 3 hours, and it'll just be a very light touch of the Hermes powder or the Dolce & Gabbana one that I have, and that's just to take if it just starts to get just a little bit more of a glow, because the way it is now I think is absolutely perfect. I think it looks really beautiful. It is a lovely foundation. I think it gives a really beautiful look to my skin, and it is just really flattering on mature skin as well. I think those that have normal to dry skin would absolutely love this foundation and definitely be able to wear it all year round. I think it's gorgeous on my oily skin as well. It's just that I don't think it would last that well in the middle of summer here. But in saying that, I do think it is really gorgeous. So now I'm just going to go out into the lounge and show you this in natural light. So in my lounge here, I have these huge windows, one big one in front of me, also to the left and right as well. And even though it is winter here today, it is a really beautiful, clear, sunny day. So hopefully you'll be able to get a good look at it. So this is what it's like. I'll just come in a little bit closer. I'm just looking in the viewfinder here, and I think it looks really gorgeous. I love it that it
doesn't settle into lines, and it definitely has that blurring effect that they mention in the description on their website. And I just think it gives the skin just a really soft, healthy, beautiful look. I'm also really loving the look of the other Clé de Peau products that I have on as well. The eyeshadow and the blush and the lipstick, it's just all over a really soft, beautiful look. So now I'll go back into my room and give my final thoughts.
So I would definitely recommend this foundation, even those of you that have oily skin like me. It's just like, as I was saying, I don't think it would wear that well or for that long during the really like the middle of summer when it is humid. But when it's cooler and there's less humidity, I think that this lasts really well. And as I was saying at the beginning of the video, I've worn this will be about the sixth time that I've worn this now. I also wore this about 2 or 3 weeks ago a couple of times when I had quite long days, and it did wear on me after about 10 to 12 hours. It didn't wear all the way off, but when it did wear, it was very even. It didn't look patchy or anything like that. I thought that it wore off really beautifully. And for those of you that have normal to dry skin, I think all year round this foundation would be absolutely gorgeous. I think it is perfect for mature skin. It gives a sort of a type of plump, hydrated look that looks super flattering on older skin. It tends to just soften the whole look. I think this is a really gorgeous foundation. So that's it for today's video. I would love it if you gave it a like and subscribed, and I will see you next time. Bye.